Right now, we are about 3 metres above what will be the concourse for Paddington Station. And to my left here is where the escalators will come down from the passengers that come out of Paddington Station, which is behind us here. And they'll come down here, and the gates are just behind you. And from there, they'll descend down another set of escalators onto the platforms at Paddington Station. So we're right in the middle of the box. It's about 255 metres long. There's over 100,000 cubic metres to be excavated out of here. And we're about nearly halfway through the excavation here at the moment. This box is built right in the middle of a road. So unlike many of the other Crossrail stations where we have ticket halls at each end of the station and what we call mined tunnels between them, here we've had the luxury of being able to put the whole station in the middle of one road. But that's come at the price of we've had to shut that road and rebuild it. So the challenge that we've had for the last 2 years is to build the diaphragm walls, that's the walls of this box, and get the lid on and reinstate the road above us within the 2 years which we agreed with Westminster and a lot of our local stakeholders. Now we really become quite focused on the underground subsurface works. We need to continue installing all these props, excavating down about 3.5 metres beneath them and carrying on through with our concourse slab, and we need to get that done by the middle of July. In the middle of July, the tunnels which have already been bored underneath us here by the two tunnel boring machines, Ada and Phyllis, they are vacated. The contractor who's working in there at the moment will finish his works, and we'll bust into those tunnels and get down to the base slab, which is and construct that. That's where the trains and the platforms will be. The team's functioning really, really well, and the opening of Eastbourne Terrace is a really good example of that. Opening a road, there's many similarities between that and opening a station. You know, there's so many different variables you've got to get it handed over. There's different services, there's the structures, you've got to get the lights in, you've got to get the utilities under it, all these things, and they all need components from all the different parts of our combined organisations to all come together. And without all the different people all pulling in the same direction and all being really focused on it, we just never would have got there, and it was always a really tight schedule, and just it's totally a result of some really good work together by those teams, just putting every distraction from their mind and every little frustration to one side and getting on with it.